Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitz of Shulchan Aruch and the laws of Erev Yom Kippur. And he says like this, Achar tefilas ha-mincha, after one davens mincha on Erev Yom Kippur, noyegin lahalkois, there's a custom that a person should receive lashes. Yes, actual lashes, not to the extent that they did in the times of the Torah, but a symbolic lashing of the person. Even though these are not actual lashes like prescribed by the Torah, talking about with a whip. When a person receives these customary lashes, it will at least put into their heart that they need to do tshuva from any of the averas, the sins that they committed. A person should take the strap made out of the skin of a calf, even though it's not a tefach wide, because when the Torah said that you have to get whipped and lashed, it had to be one tefach wide, which is about 3 to 4 inches. The one who's getting lashes, he should bend forward and kneel down. His face should be to the north, and his back should be facing towards the south. And while he's getting lashed and whipped, he should be reciting the vidui, the confessional that we say on Yom Kippur. And the one who's giving the lashes, he should say, he says these psukim from particular Tehillim, and he says it gimel pa'amim 3 times, shem lamet hastevas, that's 39 words, keneged lamet hasmalkus, which corresponds to the 39 lashes that the Torah prescribes a person to receive. We don't find this minhag so well spread in Klal Yisrael still today. The Sfardim are very still makpid on doing this. Maybe you'll find by some of the Ashkenazim and the Hasidim that do, but we don't find it as often. Perhaps it's something, especially Bizman Ezeh, when there's so much difficulties going on in Klal Yisrael, we need to really purify ourselves. Maybe it's kedai to try to bring this back, that we recognize just how severe sin is. La'esa erev, oichlin suda amavsekis, towards the evening, before the sun goes down, we have to eat what's called the suda amavsekis, the final meal. V'noigin litbol prusas hamaitzi b'dvash, the minhag is to dip the bread, so you're supposed to wash over here, you dip the bread in honey, k'moi b'Rosh Hashanah, just like we do on Rosh Hashanah. Only eat things that are easy to digest, because it has to hold your body in good stead for the next 24, 26 hours. Like chicken. The minhag is not to eat fish during this meal. Not to eat anything or drink anything that will heat the body up. Like foods that are spiced up with a lot of herbs, ukarkaim and saffron and the like, garlic they also recommend, and eggs and the like. Why not to eat? Because all these things increase one, for the man increase his seed, and we don't want that chalila, his body's going to be heated up, he's going to come to a nocturnal emission on the night of Yom Kippur, which is not a very ominous sign for the good. A person should be very careful. He has to make sure that he adds from the weekday onto the holiness of Yom Kippur, meaning he has to start Yom Kippur a drop early. He has to stop eating while it's still daytime. A little bit before Ben Hashmoshes, which is the time from Shkia, when the sun goes down, until Tseis, till the stars come up. And what is that time amount? So uzrizim magdim lahafsik kemav shah kaidim alayla. There are those that are particular and alacritous with this mitzvah. They stop even 1 hour before Laila, before it's nightfall. So the Mishnah Berurah writes that a person should try to stop eating and drinking 20 minutes before Shkia. 20 minutes before Shkia would be an appropriate time to end the eating and the drinking, and then get themselves prepared for the night and the day of Rosh Hashanah, of Yom Kippur. Let's say a person ate the meal much earlier in the day, and he has in mind look, I'm eating my meal at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, but you know what? I'm going to probably eat or drink a little bit more later on before Yom Kippur comes. I have to make sure that I get my body ready and prepared to be sustainable for the fast. Before he makes the birchas hamazon, the benching, so he must make a tanai, a stipulation. And that is v'yomer v'feirush, he has to say explicitly, oy, l'chol apachos, l'har b'libo, or at least he has to think about it in his heart. She'eino mekabel av adayinus, atayinus, he has to say to himself, even though that I'm benching right now, I'm not accepting the fast upon myself when I'm done. Rather, he has intention to eat more afterwards than he would be able to. But it would come out, according to the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, that if a person would not have this in mind, or a person would not say such a thing, even if he finished eating, let's say 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon, and Shki is not for another couple of hours, he would not be able to eat or drink anything else. So please, if you end the meal earlier, so make sure that you make this tanai, you make the stipulation, so that you're able to continue eating and drinking before Yom Kippur begins. Have a wonderful day.